Hello. In this video, you'll learn how to spec the FlowBelow Tractor AeroKit on a Class 8 truck. Before we proceed, let's talk about the items you'll need. First, ensure you have a copy of the FlowBelow spec sheet. It can be located on our website. You can either print it out and complete the form, or gather the necessary information and complete the online form, whichever you prefer. You'll also need a straight edge. We recommend a level or other rigid square-edged item. And lastly, you'll need a tape measure. After you have the items in hand, you'll be ready to begin the specking process. To ensure a proper fit, it is very important that you complete all fields in the form. If you have any questions or are not sure about measurements or info, please include photos. Now let's get started. Part 1 of the form asks for standard customer information and should be self-explanatory. Part 2 requests information that will allow FlowBelow to properly configure your wheel cover kit. First, provide the axle flange nut size on your truck by measuring the diameter of your hub bolts. 5/8 inch is by far the most common, but measure to be certain. Next, we need to know the rim size of your vehicle, which is displayed on the sidewall. We also need to know if your vehicle is equipped with a halo tire inflation system, a tag axle, or a lift axle. To determine which wheel cover latch will best fit your truck, we only require 2 measurements. First, lay a straight edge across the tire face and measure the distance from the tire face to the top edge of the axle flange nuts. Next, measure the distance from the tire face to the edge of the rim. If you're only specking FlowBelow wheel covers, no other information will be required. If you're specking the full AeroKit, there are a few more bits of information that we need in order to properly configure your center and rear fairings. First, we need to know the type of fifth wheel on your vehicle. If your fifth wheel cannot move, it is fixed. If your fifth wheel can slide forward and back, it is considered a slider. Next, we need to know your fifth wheel configuration. You'll have one of 3 possible configurations: outboard, evenly spaced, outboard, unevenly spaced, or inboard. Outboard evenly spaced is defined as an outward-facing rail with evenly spaced holes. Outward unevenly spaced has an outward-facing rail but with unevenly spaced or missing holes. Inboard applies to all rails that do not extend outward. If you're unsure about your setup, don't worry. Simply send us a photo of your fifth wheel. In our example spec, we're installing on an outboard evenly spaced fifth wheel configuration. If one of these bolts or bolt holes was missing, this would be an unevenly spaced fifth wheel configuration. Let's move along to part 4 and gather some measurements for the rear fairings. First, measure the bolt hole spacing for the mud flap hanger from center to center. Next, measure the distance between the flat surface of the frame and the outer edge of the tire tread. It's very important that you measure to the edge of the tire tread and not the tire face. It is also important that you truly measure from the frame. Be careful that you don't measure from anything that might be mounted to the frame. And that is all we need to begin processing your order. We'll take it from here. Simply scan or photograph the completed form and send via email, or finalize the online spec sheet and submit. Remember that we highly encourage you to include photos if you're unsure about any of your selections or measurements. Should you have any questions, give us a call at 512-520-5350 and a customer service specialist will be happy to help. Thanks for choosing FlowBelow, and have a great day.